Over the summer, Super Sycamore received a lot of emails asking why there wasn't another episode before the end of last year. And he didn't know the reason why. Until now. Towards the end of the school year last year, our hero was zipping around with excitement because he had another video of hard work, enthusiasm, respect, and organization to show the incredible staff and students of Sycamore Creek Elementary. And he put it where he knew our principal, Mrs. Arnold, would find it. Unfortunately, someone else found it first. Super Sinister. And he put it where no one else would find it. We all thought that the episode would be lost forever. Until recently, when Mrs. Arnold stumbled upon it.
What is going on in here? It is so hot! What was that? New episode, Play Me. The kids are gonna love it.
So with that, we give you the long lost episode.
Respect is his golden rule. Organized to be the best in school. Sycamore teachers teach the kids new things. Learning doesn't stop until the last bell rings, rings, rings. Super Sycamore comes out at night, standing super work that students do right. If you want Super Sycamore to notice you, don't be discouraged when something is hard to do. Work hard and be excited. Show respect and organize until the top you will rise.
Episode 56. It's all in the family. When we last saw Super Sycamore, it was revealed that he had a new villain to deal with. A superfan who was once devoted to Super Sycamore and who had been trained by him became a villain who was jealous of Super Sycamore. He wanted to defeat Super Sycamore and became determined to make Super Sycamore look bad. He became his new arch enemy, Super Sinister. And on this day, Super Sinister decides that destroying work isn't villainous enough. Instead, he devises a cyber attack on SCE that will shut down all technology in the building. No internet, no computers, no phones, no lights. If it's a piece of technology or it runs on electricity, it's been affected. No more heating up lunches or even washing hands. Teachers are being left in the dark.
What? That's what we're gonna do.
Electric pencil sharpeners? Not anymore. Popcorn maker? Nope. Even poor Mr. Biakko's coffee isn't safe.
No!
Super Sycamore is moving through the pod stamping super work when the cyber attack hits. He checks the light switches, but no luck. In an effort to find the problem, he checks the telecommunications hub of the building. He checks the vector images. He pushes buttons on the bitmap augmenter, and he adjusts the AGP antenna. He even alters the fiber optic GUI sensor, thinking that would help. But nothing he does brings the technology back online. So Super Sycamore finds a phone to call the one person he knows who can solve this. Unfortunately, he can't call. But in a bit of luck, he notices a fax machine that runs on a battery not affected by a cyber attack. So he faxes a note for help. When a superhero knows that a problem is too big to handle on his own, who does he call? His sister, Cyber Sycamore, who is so tech-savvy that with a push of a button, she appears at the school. If you've ever wondered what a superhero family reunion looks like, apparently it includes random dancing. With the pleasantries out of the way, they head out to fix the problem. Cyber Sycamore begins her work figuring out how the cyber attack affected the technology. Then she'll know how to attack the problem. And as she does that, Super Sycamore gets to work figuring out what worked to Super Stamp. Even if it's dark, he can still sense Super work. Like Mason's independent study project on space, and Lily's summary writing of a series of unfortunate events. Meanwhile, Cyber Sycamore sends a note by airmail for some additional supplies, which our hero will collect as he continues stamping. Grant's adjective word cloud is solid. In third grade, Landon, Jack, and Cam have been working at the Discovery Station putting together a roller coaster. Apparently, like many teachers, Cyber Sycamore needs some coffee. So, like a caring brother, he gives her some. Just kidding, it's empty.
Okay. Yeah, where's the
Meanwhile, teachers are feeling more of the effect of the cyber attack.
Oh man, nothing's working.
As Super Sycamore stamps kindergarten's Henry P. Bologna work, his sister lets him know she didn't appreciate the coffee prank. Our Caped Crusader wants you to know that even without technology, there's lots to do. For example, you can play a game of Connect 4. Hopefully, you'll have someone to play against. Otherwise, you might lose to yourself. You could also read a book. Apparently, this one's pretty good. Goes back to stamping and stamps Navani Mendoza's Me on the Map project outside Mrs. Sparling's room. You know what else you don't need technology for? Basketball and hula hooping. Show us how it's done, Super Sycamore. Without technology, you can even do writing. Yes, you'll have to use a pencil instead of a keyboard, but it is possible. And as teachers wait, Cyber Sycamore sends a note to say that she's working on it.
I've got this. I can't get this to work.
The next thing you know, Cyber Sycamore emerges from her cocoon with a victorious smile. Yep, you'll have to trust me, she is smiling. And with a simple flick of her thumb, Super Sinister's plan is ruined, and SCE is back to being up and running like normal. It goes to show you that even superheroes need to ask for help sometimes. And sometimes that help can come from family. And it looks like Cyber Sycamore was needed elsewhere. After all, a hero's job never ends.